Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we have another tutorial on how to navigate through our equipment access database. So today we have Preventive Maintenance Dashboard. So the Preventive Maintenance Dashboard tells us everything that's going on with our preventive maintenance in terms of the reminders, what PM is due, how many PMs we have ready. For instance, here we have a daily PM, one daily PM. Here we have four weekly PM, four fortnightly, four monthly, four quarterly, and three bi-yearly, and three yearly. So this reminder always shows up in based on the periods. When I say periods, I mean daily, weekly, fortnightly, monthly, quarterly, bi-yearly, and yearly. So each period has its own days that it gets you reminded. For instance, for the daily, you have every day you have a reminder if you have something scheduled. So for instance, if you're maintaining an equipment, say you're maintaining a motor or a mail, and there are certain tasks that has to be performed each day. So you have those tasks scheduled. So then you have a reminder, a daily reminder. Similar to that, for the weekly, if you have a task that is done, that is performed weekly, you have a 3-day reminder. So every 3 days you receive this reminder shows up on the dashboard. The same goes to the fortnightly. The fortnightly actually is 4 days. Fortnightly is 14 days actually, but the reminder comes in every 4 days. For the monthly, you have a 1-week reminder. For the quarterly, you have a 14 days reminder. For the bi-yearly, you have 30-day reminder. And for the yearly, you have a 45-day reminder before the reminder shows up in this format. However, there's also another form of reminder, which is by email. So 3 days before each PM is due, you have a reminder that is automatically sent on your email. And those email are prompted by this clock. So every 5 seconds, if an email hasn't been sent on a PM, a preventive maintenance that is due within 3 days, this clock automatically sends out that email. So that's what this timer is for. But once it sends out that first email, it wouldn't send another email. If you delete that email, you're not going to receive another email, because what the database does is it records each time that it sends an email, so it doesn't fill up your mailbox with unnecessary emails. So that's why I set it to only send out that email once, and that is 3 days before the PM is due. So if you want to schedule a daily maintenance, I've already have one that is scheduled. So let's go into the daily maintenance and look at that one. So when we click this, it takes us to this portal. So on my videos, I show you how to add equipment, production areas, the PM descriptions, the maintenance tech name, the service company, if there's any service company available, and put in the parts that you use in repairing the equipment. So for instance, when you put in the part, it tells you the cost of the part and how many hours you spent maintaining the equipment. And also there's rates as well. For instance, there's $30. I set it at $30 an hour. Of course, you can come in and put another figure. You can put 40, and it automatically calculates the cost of repairs. So how this works is the last updated day. So take for instance, if you maintain an equipment today, you put the day that you maintain the equipment, and it automatically calculates the next day as the due date. So today is the 3rd. So if I put today, the next due date will be on the 4th. So after I'm done, just say I've completed this maintenance, I'll come here and then I'll click I'll check this box right here. When I check this box, the red notification automatically falls off, which is something that I will show you. So once I save and close, and then I have to close this dashboard for it to refresh. So I close this form, it takes me to the main menu. I want to go back to the dashboard now, and then when I click preventive maintenance, it takes me back to dashboard. But notice one thing here, it says no daily PM due. It says no daily PM due because I checked the box in this portal. I checked this box saying that I have completed this PM. However, this will not fall off from this. This will always show for the next 24 hours. So it shows for next 24 hours and for here. So once that date, once it passed the 4th, this PM drops off. You're not going to see it on this portal. However, you can see it on this portal. So let's say we want to view our PM records, the complete and incomplete PM. So when we go in this portal, it shows us that you have to actually click this box, check this box here. Once you check this box, it shows you the PM that has been completed, which is this one that we just checked. If we uncheck the box, it shows PM that hasn't been completed. For now, we have none that hasn't been completed. So when we check it again, it shows us the one that has been completed. So this is how to see a PM that has already dropped off from this portal. However, if you want to see all the records all at the same time, you can go here and click here, and it shows you all the PMs that you have on your records. When you scroll all the way, it takes you to all the records. So that's how the same thing goes for the weekly, fortnightly, and just for an example, let's go in and check out the weekly. When you go through the portal for the weekly, it says I have 4 weekly. So we have 4 here. 1, 2, 3, 4. You have 4 weekly. So after you've completed it, say you're trying to do it ahead of time and you do it today. So this one was scheduled on the 27th. So if you want to complete it, you can just go in and click complete here. And when you save and close, it is 4. But when I close the form to refresh, go back, now it's 3. So when you check this box here, it automatically drops it off from the reminder list. So mind you, it won't drop off from here till the date is complete, till it gets to the 4th. So that's when it automatically drops off. And just like the daily, you can go back here, the weekly, and when you check the box, it shows you which ones has been completed and which ones hasn't been completed yet. So that's how the dashboard works. Also, there is populate PM list and add equipment on an email list. So these ones are also important. So let me give you a brief explanation of how this works. So when you go to the daily, so this PM descriptions that tells you what you're actually doing. So these are all the equipments that are on the database. So let's say we are performing a maintenance for the Amada Aqueous 2515, the laser punch. So once we click this button, this drop down, we click this machine, it tells us what production area where it's located, and also the PM description gives us all the operations that we're performing. So this PM description, you can populate it from here. This is where you populate it. So as you can see, the job list is the PM description. So, and this is the equipment. So the equipment is already in the system. If you go to some of my videos, I will show you where I showed you how to put in the equipment. And then you can categorize this based, you can link the equipment to the job list. So if you have an operation that needs to be performed on an equipment, you can come in here and at the operation and link it up to a particular equipment. So when you want to schedule the PM, you just go in here and you schedule it. When you bring in a new equipment, the production area shows up. This is the serial number of the equipment. And here you could put in the job list or the PM description. And if you have a document that you want to attach, you can link in a document that tells you how the PM needs to be performed. So you can link in a document. It's very easy to navigate. So that's how the preventive maintenance dashboard works. So it gives you everything you need to maintain an equipment. Thank you. Well, if you need more information about how to get this database, I have a link to my on the description on how to get the database. It's a very low cost fee. One time fee that you have to pay for it. Most of the database out there cost thousands of dollars and requires constant maintenance, but this database is a one and done. Once you purchase it, you can use it. You know, it doesn't require, provided you have a Microsoft Access database, you can always use it in any manufacturing environment. You can also split the database so multiple users can use it at the same time. All right, thank you.